Croup is an upper airway disease that causes acute respiratory distress in children. It's caused by a viral infection which triggers the inflammation of the larynx, trachea, and bronchi. That's why it's also known as laryngotracheobronchitis. Croup is classically characterized by a barking cough, inspiratory stridor, and a hoarse voice. Let's talk about the etiology of Croup now. 75% of the time, it's caused by the parainfluenza virus. However, it can also be caused by other viruses like influenza, adenovirus, and respiratory syncytial virus. Historically, diphtheria, which is a bacterial infection, would cause similar features and was described as a diphtheric croup. This is now extremely rare in immunized areas, so today, when you come across croup, think about it exclusively as a viral illness. On history, croup will typically present with low-grade fevers and coryzal symptoms that are often worse at night. It typically affects children between the age of 6 months and 6 years old, peaking at the age of about 2. On examination, you might notice a seal-like barking cough, stridor, which is a high-pitched sound, loudest on inspiration and over the trachea. It indicates there's obstruction or narrowing of the upper airways. This should be differentiated from a wheeze, which tends to be louder on expiration and usually indicates a lower obstruction, like asthma or COPD. Croup can also present with a hoarseness of voice and increased work of breathing. Moving on to the investigation of croup, it's important to know that because croup is a clinical diagnosis, no investigations are usually needed. Actually, they might cause further distress and the worsening of symptoms. In saying this, you might see in old textbooks a classic finding of croup on an anterior-posterior neck x-ray. This is known as Steeple's sign. This refers to the subglottal tracheal narrowing, which is reminiscent of a church steeple. After a history and examination, you need to assess the severity of croup to determine what your management will be. Croup is stratified into mild, moderate, and severe croup. A number of scoring systems have been made for research purposes, like the Westley Croup score, but they're often not used clinically. This is just my easy way of assessing the severity of croup as mild, moderate, or severe based on my local guidelines in Australia. I think of the effort, the effectiveness, and the extra sounds a patient is making. Someone with mild croup will have near effortless work of breathing with the use of no accessory muscles. They'll be alert because they're effectively oxygenating their blood and won't have any added sounds like stridor at rest. Someone with moderate croup, on the other hand, will have increased respiratory rates, moderate use of accessory muscles, and they'll start to be getting agitated because of the ineffective breathing. They might also have intermittent stridor at rest. Finally, if a child has marked chest wall retractions, they're looking really toxic or drowsy, and have persistent stridor at rest, they probably have severe croup. Some things to keep in mind are that the loudness of stridor is not a good guide to the severity of obstruction, and that hypoxia is a late sign, which indicates very life-threatening croup. The management of croup is dependent on its severity, with a couple of exceptions. All patients should be minimally handled, kept with a carer, and allowed to adopt a comfortable position by themselves. Mild and moderate croup are both primarily managed with oral prednisolone or dexamethasone. Following this, an observation period of at least 30 minutes should occur. If they've improved and have been stridor-free at rest for a total of 30 minutes post-steroids, they can be sent home. If they deteriorate, they should be treated as having severe croup. Severe croup requires both steroids and nebulized adrenaline. If there's a poor response, repeat the dose and then get ICU involved. If it does work, a minimum observation period of at least 4 hours or longer should be followed before discharging them. Some important things to remember about the management of croup is that supplemental oxygen is not usually required, but if it is, presume that they have severe croup. You should always defer IV access to reduce the stress of a child. And don't forget, croup is usually worse at night. Let's summarize with two mnemonics. Croup, also known as laryngotracheobronchitis, is a viral infection and it can cause mild, moderate, or severe respiratory distress based on the effort, effect, and extra sounds of breathing. You can remember most of what I've said with the six S's of croup. A child will present with croup between the ages of 6 months and 6 years old. They'll present with stridor, a seal barking cough, and although no investigations are usually required, an AP neck X-ray will show Steeple's sign. Everyone is managed with steroids, and in severe cases, steamed adrenaline. Another good mnemonic to remember all the differentials of upper respiratory distress in a child is abcafe. A for abscess, like a quinsy, B for bacterial tracheitis, C for croup, A for anaphylaxis, F for foreign body, like this little SpongeBob, and E for acute epiglottitis. Thank you so much for watching. Click on that little notification bell for more content, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to Townsend Teachings.